moment of force or torque that today we are going to discuss here. We know the force, and if we are applying a force on any object, it gives either it in acceleration or we can say change in velocity. Okay, so here if we see the effects of force, so suppose if we are using if we are applying a force, or if you want to open a door or open a window, what we are going to do, we are applying a force on its handle. When we are applying a force on its handle, the door turns on its hinges, and what we are getting the turning effect. So when we are applying a force, if we are applying a very small force, the effect of the turning will be the lesser one, and if we are applying a larger force, then what we are getting the more the turning effect. So here the force has an effect of turning. So we can say the effect of force, that we can say it is a turning effect. When we are applying a force, suppose if we are having this, we can say this is a door which is connected like this, and we are applying a force in this direction, so it will be having a turning effect in the direction of the force about its axis, about this axis, about its hinges. So we can say if we are applying a smaller force here, there will be a smaller turning effect, and if we are applying a larger force, we are getting a larger turning effect. Okay, now means what we are getting a turning effect because of the force, turning effect because of the force. Now we can say means the turning effect, that we can also called as that moment of force or torque. Now this moment of force or torque, as we have seen, that when we are applying this force, it is turning, it has the effect of turning. Now there will be a perpendicular distance here. Here if we are applying a force here, suppose this is your handle, and if we are applying a force, so this is the axis of rotation, that we can say, because there are the hinges, and it will have a turning effect about this. So this moment of force or torque depends on, first thing, the magnitude of the force, and second thing is the perpendicular distance of the line of action, of the force from the axis of rotation. And this is, we can say this is the axis of rotation, and here if we are applying a force, so this will be a perpendicular distance of the line of action of the force from the axis of rotation. Now this perpendicular distance, we can call it as a lever arm. What we can call it as a lever arm, or we can say moment arm. What we can say, moment arm. Now here it is depending on these two factors, magnitude of the force. The greater the magnitude of the force, the greater the greater the perpendicular distance of the line of action of the force from the axis of rotation, the greater the moment of force or torque. So here now we have got this moment of force or torque. Now we can define this torque or moment of force, that we can say that we can define it like this. It is the turning effect. It is the turning effect of the force. Turning effect of the force about the axis. About the axis of rotation. Axis of rotation means we can say it is the it is measured as the product of magnitude of the force and the perpendicular distance between the line of the action. Between the line of action of the force. Suppose if we are having example, if we are having a body just like this in a shape, and in a shape like this, here we are applying a force in this direction, say F, and the body is rotating in this direction. This is the axis of rotation, that we can say axis of rotation. Now if we are applying a force in this direction, and we can say this is the point of force or direction, that is perpendicular distance, means this 90 degree that we can assume. So this is the point N, and here we can say M, and this is the line of action of force, that we can say this is the line of action of force, line of action of force. This is the axis of rotation. We are applying a force in this direction. This is the line of action, and this is the perpendicular distance. Say we assume it as a D, suppose. So here, what we have got? We have got torque is equal to force into perpendicular distance between the line of action of the force. So here we can substitute force. We are taking it as F, and the perpendicular distance here we have assumed D. Now torque that we denoted by tau. Torque that we generally denoted by tau. So what we have got, tau is equal to F into D. Tau is the torque, F is the force, and D is the perpendicular distance between the line of action of the force. Okay. So what we have got? We have got torque. Other we can say it, torque is equal to force into this lever arm or momentum arm. Force into lever arm, or the distance of the length of the lever arm, that we can say. This is the lever arm, that we can say. Or momentum. Okay. So what we have got? Now you will see here the dimensions of torque. What we will see? We will see the dimensions of torque. Here what we have got, tau is equals to F into D. Now we know that torque is equal to force into distance. In general language we can say distance. Now distance that we generally take it in dimensions as L. Now we know the dimensional dimensions of force that we can say m l t raised to the power minus 2 tau is here. So ultimately what we are getting here, m l square t square minus 2. This is the dimension we have got, m l square t raised to the power minus 2. Now we can have units of torque also. Units of torque, now here again we will take tau is equal to force into distance. Now the unit of force in SI system, that is Newton, and the distance that we are taking it as a Newton meter. So in MKS or in SI units of this torque is Newton meter. It is Newton meter in SI system. Similarly, if we go with the CGS system, the unit of the torque will be dyne into centimeter. So ultimately we can write it dyne centimeter. Dyne centimeter. Here what we have got? Now we have got the moment of force or torque. In that we have discussed about the effect of force, how we have got the turning effect. And because of the turning effect, we have got the moment of force or torque. After that, we come to conclusion with this tau is equals to F into D. Dimensions of torque that we can define with the help of torque is equal to force into distance. We know the dimensions of force, that is m l t raised to the power minus 2 into l, and tau is equals to m l square t raised to the power minus 2. Similarly, units of torque that we can have in SI system, Newton into meter, Newton meter, and dyne into centimeter, that is dyne centimeter.